people in bygone eras would make up poems or ballads about ghosts convening and partying at this time of year because of superstitions that the dead would rise from their graves for one last fun blitz before the onset of winter and the cold.
Oh, the mayor is over there with the person on the bicycle. He's right over there.
When am I supposed to do this? At the beginning?
No, not now, when we're at the ballpark.
Yeah, but before we give out the awards.
Just before you give out the awards, yes. You gotta come on strong, a little bit like Orson Welles did for the War of the Worlds radio cast. Oh my gosh!
I don't know if I can pull that off, but I'll try.
There really is something out there, and here it comes.
We have a Halloween legend in our midst today. We have the Ghost of King Spectrum, and you can always tell the Ghost of King Spectrum by her shiny silver beads around her neck.
As far as the name Spectrum goes, another term for ghost is specter. I thought Spectrum was more attractive because in using the colors of the rainbow, I could make myself identifiable by wearing rhinestones to establish myself as some kind of ghost VIP.
I first met Suzanne at a Christmas parade where she was Underdog, and after the parade she was signing autographs and asking people for rides to Ocean City, and I was feeling daring and I gave her one. We went to Motel 6 and I photographed her relaxing in her civvies, as she calls it. She puts on like a little apron sometimes over her costume so people don't get confused by her out in public. And I got her number and went to various other parades and kept trying to figure her out. She doesn't make any excuses for why a person can't make their art, so she can make it to the parade, why can't I make it there to photograph her? She's completely direct emotions all the time. There's no bottling up of anything. She'll be, you know, like, oh, we're gonna do this and we're gonna do that, and then all of a sudden she'll notice something wrong in her costume and she'll just get sad and sit down, and then all of a sudden something else will happen and she's like, oh, and she's happy again, or in a split second she'll be mad. She does like to be photographed, but you have to be fast because she won't stand still. So tonight we're going to try to photograph her in the moonlight, so I need like an 8-second exposure or something. It should be interesting. So this is one event that I have missed every year, Halloween night on the beach. I'm not sure what exactly happens. I'm curious to see whether or not it's a performance or if it's a ritual or some sort of real experience where there are ghosts.
The Spectrum's necklace is supposed to glitter like that anytime he spins, and well, he's coming forward, the ghost seeing the diamond sparkle in the torches or whatever lighting they have for their parties, and they know, there he is, he's coming!
So you're summoning up, okay, the wave. What are you waving to?
I'm waving to the ghosts.
And they're departing?
No,
is that the case?
They're all around us now. They'll be partying until daybreak tomorrow.
Oh, okay. How exactly do they party? They're dancing?
It's all over, and all the ghosts disappear for another year.
Where do they go?
Into the great beyond.
So how does this make you feel the next day? Now that you've, come out here and you dance with the ghosts. Do you feel sort of purged yourself?
Well, no, I mean the next day, I have a letdown feeling. All the
really
the holiday's over for another year.
What do you think about photos?
It's nice that they're being taken, but then it's also important to know what the end result is going to be. I'm concerned whether I become really famous and renowned or end up being just another Jane Doe. I can't take it easy. I have to keep going, especially now that I'm a lot older.
But are you ever happy?
Sometimes. When I'm working on my costumes, I feel happy, or when I'm working on craft projects. I'm always striving for perfection. It's a labor of love. It's striving to keep in practice at some ability that God gave me.
Mm-hmm. At her house, there was nothing except what she needs to do her art. It was completely sparse. Just a TV, couch, and then her sewing station, and a closet. It's full of capes and capes and capes.
I call this one Bridal Witch. Roman soldier in his military outfit. Cinderella, although in this case it's Irish style. The outfit I use for St. Patrick's parades. Sunny Susie, the summer sunshine mermaid. Supergirl. I wore this one in 89 to go along with the 25th anniversary of Underdog's origin, and since the symbol of the 25th anniversary is silver, he had to have a silver cape.
The way she puts it, God gives you a gift. God gives everybody a gift, and if you don't use it, then you're a sinner. And if you use it well, then you can be a hero.